Good morning. We just have a few announcements. Most of them are in the bulletin and on this pink sheet, so please be aware of those things. I hope you all received, either by email or by U.S. mail, an update prepared by the Salem relaunch team. If you didn't receive this letter, let me know and I'll see that you get one. The letter outlined what we think, what we really believe is going to happen this fall with Sunday school and a variety of church projects. While almost everything we do will be affected, we want to try to bring as much normalcy, that's a really odd word, normalcy as possible to our regular projects. The idea, however, is that in all we do, the safety of everyone is uppermost. As we move through the fall, we're going to continue to encourage everyone to get vaccinated and wear masks when inside the building. Two things to remember. Vaccinations save lives and help keep folks off ventilators, and masks help those around you. You'll notice that in the bulletin there's an announcement that the installation of the new sound system components is going to start Tuesday and Wednesday, actually this Thursday instead. Many of you know about the passing of our brother in Christ, Jerry Ogden. Jerry and Deb were regulars at the Sunday evening service, and Jerry participated in the Vision Sunday School class. There will be a celebration of his life this Wednesday morning, September 1, at 10 o'clock here at the church with Reverend Martinez officiating. The service will follow a brief visitation from 9 to 10. I'm sure that we all extend our sympathies to the Ogden family. The flowers in front of the sanctuary this morning are in memory and honor of Jose Martinez, Pastor Martinez's father, who passed away earlier this week. I'm sure the entire Martinez family would appreciate your continued thoughts and prayers for comfort, healing, and peace. Thanks.
I have called my name, you are mine.
He promises our troubles will not overwhelm us. Even when we pass through fire, we will not be burned, and our trials will not hurt us.
He is the Holy God of Israel, who sent you.
The steps are bigger depending on how small you are. Well, I've got a question for you this morning. What do you think you need to do to show people that you are a follower of Jesus? Any ideas? No. Do you think it needs to be something big, like build a cathedral or feed an entire city of people? No. Could it be something as simple as giving someone a glass of water when they're thirsty? Do you think so? Yeah. Do you think it could be something as simple as giving someone a hug when they're sad? What do you think? Telling them that they're loved and it's going to be okay. Yeah. In the gospel reading later in the service, we're going to see that Jesus says it is simple as giving someone a cool glass of water in his name. Loving people for who they are, where they are, and even if they're like that. Especially. But following Jesus is something as simple as loving our neighbors. It doesn't have to be complicated, and we tend to overcomplicate things. And adults are good at that, aren't they? They like to make lots of complicated rules. Have you experienced that yet? Yeah. Adults like to make things overly complicated, but really, if you want to be a follower of Jesus, it's as simple as loving your neighbor and making sure they're taken care of. Do you think you can do that, especially as school starts this fall? Yeah. Make some new friends, take care of people, share things you have. Does that sound like a thing you can do? Yeah? Why don't we say a prayer together? Gracious and loving God, we ask that you give us the faith of children to see everyone in Fond du Lac and in Wisconsin and in the world as our neighbors. And we especially ask for prayers, as we did last week, for those children throughout the world in places like Afghanistan and Haiti who especially need our love and our prayers during this difficult time. We ask all of this in the name of your Son, Christ our Lord. Amen. Thanks for coming up.
Thank you.
Also, I'd like to express my gratitude to you all for taking care of myself and my family because we lost our daddy in Honduras. To not be allowed to be with a family at this time add extra grief to my soul. But thank you for your prayer, especially also for this present. I will thank you. Take picture and send my family from you today at the world's service. Appreciate it. I know my daddy is in heaven and he met again with my mom. She passed away 10 years ago. Thank you. Other joints and concerns? Okay, prayer with me. Holy and Almighty God, we leave into your care our joys and concerns as we express to you at this moment, and we pray for those concerns that you know we have in our heart. Because we know you are our God, full of mercy and grace, we cross in you our joys and concerns. knowing you work and care for all, even we can't see it or does not understand. Give us a sense of peace that we might to offer that peace to others. And through the power of the Holy Spirit, equip us with your love, grace, and mercy to offer your love, hope, and healing peace to others in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, Savior, and Redeemer. Amen. Now, join with me at our prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. From the times, the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Please stand up and sing the next kingdom. In the book, Black Book, please. Number 2164. Call us to be offered our tithes and Join with me the offer of glory prayer. Glorious God, we thank you for trusting us to the breath of your glory, for claiming us as your own with all of creation. We give you thanks and praise as you receive this gift and offering. Receive us also, blessing all together, that our gifts and our lives might be a blessing that honors and glorifies you. Amen. And now, join together that absolutely, please tell us. For me, it's so hard to understand part of this Bible version we read today. Because it's so hard to cut my hand and I can live without just one hand. It's so hard for me to think I need to take off my eyes. It's so hard for me to think to lose one foot. How I can live with that? So deep, you understand? Well, the question is this. Why Jesus appointed? Why? Maybe you might have read an answer I had before. Somebody else would like to share the one answer. Let me help you. It is so important, sorry, to recognize that importance to be saved, because the connection is to be in the heaven. We need to understand it is so important to keep our salvation. It's a gift from God, but we need the action to protect our salvation. We are saved by grace. But that includes everyone called to take care about this step in the coming future. We will be in the heaven. We will take care of our life, be holy life. It's not necessary that I may take this world as ground, because something by hand we made it. Those things we made may be to express my concern about my salvation. Those ways I walk also show me I take care of my salvation. And also the thing I saw or I see also help me to keep my clear mind. I am saved from Jesus Christ. That's in the meaning of understanding, but maybe you have another. For the topic about today is also the disciple going in the mission field. Sorry. And they find other person to do their work. And also another important of this moment is, what is sorrow? What is the mean peace for us? Personal peace, my understanding, is a state of well-being with ourselves, with myself. That is important. That is important. Because my experience in the life is this. Many times, for me, it's better or very easy to complain about others. I'm talking about myself. I know myself. Complain for others. Include my wife. But you know what she did? She wants to complain about me. Why is not the coffee in the right position in front of this? For instance, you know I am a coffee person. Take additional coffee person. I know it. Cookies. And if you like cookies, come Saturday evening for ourselves or wonderful cookies. You know it's that important. Come and enjoy with us. I complain with my children. Why they do not call me today as usually they did? I'm concerned when I call them, hey, why you are not calling today? Then they say, Daddy, I am busy. Daddy, I have to do something at that moment. Forgive me. Sure, I forgive them. To keep my peace in my heart is so critical, because I learned from somewhere from my life that the reason I am not with peace in myself is the consequence of the others. Others cause me to not be in peace. Do you imagine that? I hope you are not in the same experience that I have. The other caused me to lose my peace. I feel angry. I feel hating others. Because they with me in that line, in that wrong way. Because I had a right to treat them at the right way. That is too comfort inside our heart. He made me rest up completely. To others, against the others. We need to stop. Stop forgetting others. We are a peacemaker, not troublemakers. In general, peace is the absence of conflict. In general. Therefore, I am at peace with everyone. Divine peace is a peace from God. My peace I give. I give you. My peace I give you. As a peace from God, peace is a spiritual truth. And as a spiritual truth, peace becomes a blessing. Those who work for peace will be called children of God. Christians should strive for peace with all people. Christians are called to be in peace with each other. Impossible, the Bible says. So far as it depends upon you, live with peace with all. Peacemakers are those who create peace, not the conflict. Those who reconcile with their in separation. But John said to him, "Teacher, we saw a man who was driving out demons in your name, and we called him a stop, because he doesn't belong to our group." "Do not try to stop," Jesus replied. "Because no one who performs a miracle in my name will be able, soon afterward, to say evil thing about me. For whoever is not against us is for us. I sure you that anyone who gives you a drink of water because you belong to me will certainly retrieve a drink." Jesus' disciple John had been following the Master faithfully for years. He had been right there with Jesus, and he thought about God's law, and he had seen Jesus heal that sick person. If anyone should know how Jesus wanted things done in his name, it was John. One day, John and the other disciples saw someone they did not know casting out demons in Jesus' name. Someone who had not been with them as they followed Jesus from family. A person who had not been instructed at the Master's feet was taking upon himself to do Jesus' work. John tried to stop this person, and he stood up from the integrity of Jesus. He made sure that the Lord's work was done the right way. He told Jesus what he had done, and he was expecting work. For upholding thy standards. But Jesus said, "Do not stop him, for no one who does a deed of power in my name will be able soon afterward to speak evil of us. Whoever is not against us is for us." What is that when the people who are talking. The people need to hear the good news. It is better that we serve him imperfectly than not serve him at all. It is better that we do something for him than that we do nothing while we wait to make sure that he is right. John considered that he was right to stop the person who was killing in Jesus' name. But the mission of Jesus is object. You know, we need more people outside to tell the gospel, to tell the good news. From the beginning, almost from the beginning, we endure in ministry. I invite you to be with me at the prayer walk, remember. And I will repeat forever until the last Sunday I will be with you here. Prayer walk is a simple way to share the good news for others, even if they do not ask. We are there for them. Soon we will have another set for how we can do the prayer walk during our day time. The prayer walk is embrace the community in Jesus' hand. It's expression our love for others. To be a Christian is not focused in ourselves. And my prayer is, God bless me. Give me more prosperity. Give me more health. It's not that to be called Christian. That is true, but it's not. When we are changed, it's for others. That is what Jesus expects from us. He called us and sent us into the world to make fruit to endurance. We need more persons like this to do the good thing in the person's life, in the community. There are another portion I'd like to look at to make that reflection with salt. Salt is good. We use the salt for everything. But the one thing for salt, when I use it my soup, I can see the salt inside. Disappear. Here in the same house.
but about me.
Where are you seeing that? How do you not know? Also, for a little history, the quiet and sword is so important. Where the sword is the one of the most precious commodities. Sword was included by the early Egyptians as an offering in palms in a funeral of respect. People, it was one of the key elements in the development of civilization around the world. Sword was used by comparing athletes who would spread in on conquered cities to symbolize a pure of each rehabilitation, sword in the air. Sword becomes so valuable because it was highly desired as a sustaining for tool or for healing. Also, it was valued because it was so difficult to obtain. Sword was first developed for people to use a city by evaporating the water from the salt water and by collecting it from the edges of the cities. So what does Jesus mean when he said, salt is good, but it loses its substance? How can you make its substance again? In conclusion, my brother and sister, to be a salt in this world, inside our friends, inside our neighborhood, inside in our workplace, inside in our community, and from here to the rest of the state and the world. How to be sorry one single word? Be correct. Be parents with others. Be parents. And women. In effect, the best thing comes from the other, not the bad things. Be parents with your neighbor. I remember one night in my family home, in my city home in Honduras, my mom was so kind. She cleaned the house inside early in the morning, and also in the back side, and also in front, in that part of the street. But you know, we had quite late for one time. That person cleaned that portion for that part of the street, sharing the street that house with the house, and he put that car to my in front of our house. Put the whole trash put right there. It's okay, she's doing her side, but she knows my mom for any more trash. That's fine. Because I never heard any word complain of my mom. Never. She said, I can't care. That's all she said. I can't care. Imagine, for all night and so busy, my mom was so good. We don't know what happened in the life of the other person. We don't know, but we need to show that we know them by action. That is one. And also, to be sorry for others. They stop complaining. They stop complaining. And you will be sorry. And you will see the difference. When you stop to complain. Just don't get any other. I thank you. But the Bible says, cut up your tent. Put out your eyes. Cut up your neck. Take that responsibility yourself. is that word, other, you saw the word in other, is your responsibility. It's not them, it's you. If they fall, it's because I didn't like the part. It's good to recognize our responsibility to not cross the boundaries. It's easy to complain. Stop complaining. Assume your responsibility. I took my responsibility. When I saw other fall, instead of my family, my wife, I said, no, it's my fault. Thank you for letting me. I will do a bad thing I can do in the next time. Please forgive me. Solution. Solution. Peacemaker. To be solved. To be solved. Today, before you pray, I got the opportunity to be in conversation with my sister, lovely voice. One week, and it's a great week. Sometimes when I be exposed to people like her, the mother to the church, with this great gift, I said that maybe I was in the last moment when you not share the gift, because they will have that before me. But today I ask her about seeing the song, maybe a channel of your peace. Please be in a moment of reflection on today's message as you listen to her singing. Communion of the Holy Spirit be always with you.